What is up, guys? The PC Farmer here today, and today we're going to be doing a mod review on the new Fendt pack that I've just found on one of the mod sites, which is FS15LT. I believe this is only version 1 of the pack, but I'm hoping there'll be new versions coming out because it does have a few bugs, and some of the tractors aren't quite as good quality as I hoped. And as I'm saying that, I believe a train is just coming past, and it had to be one of the freight trains. Okay, so now the train has gone past, and I can actually hear what I'm saying. And as you can see, there are a lot and a lot of tractors in this pack. I haven't actually counted how many, but you can see there's a large amount of tractors going up from small to large and older to modern. I mean, we've got well, I'll show you that in a bit, but we've got two combines in this pack as well, one slightly smaller one pretty large scale one. Okay, the first tractor we're looking at is the 515C. As you can see from when I said at the start of the video, it has a couple of bugs. I think you can see which the bug is. It's slowly moving forward. But anyway, let's get into it. So, without it, I don't know, it's going to keep moving around, I think. It's got standard IC controls in, I mean, not any advanced ones. I mean, it's got the odd warning board and all that, but I think that's fairly basic. No interactive controls as in lowering or picking up implements and that, but it's not too bad for a fairly basic tractor. Now I'm going to turn it off and see if it stops juntering around, and it's still going to, but oh well, by the end of this video might be down there. So we've got a 611. This is I really enjoyed using the tractor. I've used it a little bit. I believe this one does have a front, yeah, it does have a front loader implement involved, so I'm thinking about on my Nay as well farm that I'm going to be doing soon, be adding in this tractor, because it's a fairly basic tractor, but it has the front loader involved. Now it obviously does have a fair few amount of IC controls, but fairly basic like the other tractor. Okay, we've got a 615, which is a slightly bigger one. I believe it's got slightly more horsepower. Fairly basic again. I mean, pretty much exactly the same. I'm guessing it's modelled by the same person. I'm just rushing through these tractors. I mean, I'm going to show you some of them in action, but I won't have time to show every single one in action because there's so many of them. Now into the 824. Jumping around a bit. I'm not quite sure. It wasn't doing this yesterday, this tractor, but oh well, I'm starting to find out the bugs. Like the other ones, it's got standard IC controls. Obviously, one of the only ones that I know of that can open the front window up. Because in a real tractor, well, in the tractors that I've ever driven, you can't. But I'm guessing there probably are some that you can open the front window up on. So now on to the 828. So now we're on to the, I call the bigger, more modern tractors. Got a fair few IC controls like the other one, like got the odd front arm button and all that. I'm going to start this one up so you can hear the engine going. It's not bad sound quality. The motor has done pretty well. As you can see, the lights are down, but if you do that, they come up a lot, unlike a lot of these tractors, and also some of the tractors down there also have that. But yeah, this tractor is I've used a couple times and I'm starting to like it. Now on to the 927 Vario. Now this is where they start to get rather good, I believe, with the IC controls. Now that is the one thing that I love about this tractor. You can just literally turn it around like that. And I believe, to be honest, I'm not really sure. I think this is for more implements when you work at the back, like logging and all that. I can imagine this being a really useful mod for logging. But yeah, this is a get the engine started up. It's pretty standard. The only thing I don't like about this is obviously the mirrors blanked out, but oh well. It's still not a bad mod. Let's turn the engine off. Now into the, I think this is the 930, that's it. Yep. So much more basic, but it does have the interactive controls. The cab light, I've turned it on, I've had a play around with this already, but it turns on every single light, but I'm not really sure. Another front window, got a couple more IC controls. You can activate the computer, but I think you believe you have to have the tractor on, like I just turned it on then. I mean, you got plenty of IC controls to play around with in this tractor, but still keeping with the sort of basic look. Now into the 936. I actually haven't been in this tractor yet, so I'm not quite sure what it's like. Don't really know too much of that, what works and what doesn't, but yeah, this tractor doesn't look too bad from first appearances. Just again with the oh, it sounds good though. Sounds rather alright. But the mirrors again, which is another thing that I'm not a big fan of if they don't work. Now into the 939 Vario, so getting even bigger now. We have, this is a good tractor that I've have been in quickly. Starting, you can see the mirrors working well. I mean, I'll turn on the engine. But the only issue with this tractor is it is basic because there are no IC controls. IC controls aren't, like, you don't need them, but I think every single mod that has them just makes it a lot better mod and means that it can be a bit better than the other ones. Now, this is the tractor with more IC controls than I have ever known. You can see from the start how many buttons is. Panels, you can open, take off the mudguard, bonnet, put the wheel up, put the seat with little colour, you can change the colour of your interior. You can lift up the armrest, you can put the seat up, you can, I don't know what this one is, I'm not 100% sure, obviously close the door like on all of them. Go around here, you can put out the warning lights, I believe. No, not on this one, but yeah, it's a lot of IC controls for you to play around with. You can even put a telephone in. I mean, how many mods do you know that you can do that? I mean, a call box. It's just so you can customize your tractor much more, to be honest with you, but which, to be honest, I really like about this mod. But start up the engine quickly. Pretty standard, to be honest, but not a bad sound. Right, let's turn it off and get into this. Now, I have never seen one of these before. The Fendt Tri-6, I believe it's pronounced, but I may be wrong, I'm not sure. Now, this thing is an absolute beast. I'm going to show you it quickly. I'll quickly go through all of these in a minute, but I'll show you. This has 1,000 horsepower, it says, which I was like, oh my. Which, to be honest, with a machine this size, I'm not surprised, but I mean, we'll get it started up. And then, so to be honest, it doesn't sound as beefy as it looks, but no IC controls. Steering is front and back, but not middle, I believe. I don't think you can do anything else. No, there's no extra controls for it. But altogether, it doesn't look a bad mod. I mean, I don't know really what jobs you could use it for, but I mean, if you've got some like heavy ploughing on that, but who knows. I mean, if you guys find any use for this mod, please let me know, because I do want to have a go at this, but I mean, it is rather expensive, I believe. If you go across to mods, onto tractors, loads of tractors in here, it's probably going to be a pain to find there. It's 387,000, which, to be honest, isn't too bad, but still rather expensive if it's a tractor you're only going to use every so often to maybe pull a huge plough or something. I mean, it's rather expensive. Now on to the combines. Now, this Fendt is the smaller one. It's the 8350. I'm not entirely sure what the cutting width is, because on the cutter bio, it does not say what the width is. Inside, it looks rather good, I think. It has no IC controls, but I mean, it does look pretty realistic, to be fair. It's got all the sort of sort of buttons you want. I mean, these buttons over there, where you can say it says 0, 0, it is the mile speed you're going, so it does actually tell you the speed you're going. But yeah, it looks a pretty decent mod. I will start it up and then unfold it so you guys can see. I mean, it looks like a bit of a box, to be honest with you, but I mean, I do like that about the Fendt. So, I don't know, it's not got a huge tank. I believe it's got a 5,000 capacity, but I will check. On the harvesters it will be, wouldn't it? So, it's 5,000, yeah. I mean, it's not that expensive either. It's only 102,000, I believe it was, to buy, or something like that. But 5,000 litre capacity, which isn't too bad. But anyway, the headers, I'll go into the headers and show you quickly. These are the two headers you can buy, slightly bigger ones, slightly smaller ones. Not tell you how big. I'm guessing the 720 maybe means 7.2 metres, but I may not be right. I mean, who knows? I'll soon figure out. If anyone knows, please put it in the comments, because I'm not entirely sure if it is 7.2 metres, but that would be my guess. Also, it comes with a corn header, which is a six-row corn header, as you can see. Right, let's turn this off and get into the bigger one. Now, this Fendt is the 9460R. This is the bigger one. It comes with two different cutters. The Fendt 8200 Flex, which is a 10.5 meter, which I have on, and it comes with a power flow header, which is another one like this, but instead it's just 9.3 meters, making it 1.2 meters smaller. But I thought I'd put the bigger one on to show you. Now, I do like the look of this mod a lot. I don't know why, it's just something about it. Now, the IC controls and all that are pretty good in this mod, I think. So I can bring the wheel forward. Obviously, you can open the ladder. I mean, that's, I didn't actually notice that one. I thought that would be the door, but maybe not. Don't actually know if you can open the door, thinking about it. Maybe not. Okay. you have more controls over here. Grain tank. You can open and close the grain tank, which I'm guessing might unfold it, to be honest with you. I'm not entirely sure. Yep, it does. Another good thing you can do inside the cab. You can activate the chopper. You can do the pipe. You can put the cutter on and off, which I think is another good thing, and there is the pipe going out. So altogether, looking around this mod, it does look a very nice mod, to be fair, and I think this is something that I may end up using on one of my Let's Plays, but who knows. So I haven't showed the in action, but I mean, there's so many to show you, I just wouldn't have time to go through every single one. I mean, the video is already pretty long. I wanted to keep it as quick as possible. But I mean, definitely I would advise downloading this mod. Like I said, it's got, look, I mean, you can see the tractor down there, it's jumped all the way down there. I mean, it's starting to work its way away. But I think overall, a lot of these mods in the pack do not have bugs or anything. They're just the odd one that likes to move around on its own. But yeah, definitely download this mod pack. I mean, it is a rather large mod pack, but I mean, you've got a tractor for every scenario, so altogether, it's not that bad. And I mean, you've got combines as well, so where can you go wrong? If you like this video, please like, and if you want to see more mod reviews or Let's Plays, please put in the subscribe. And any questions you have, please don't be afraid to put in the comments, and I'll try to reply as soon as possible.